Welcome back everyone. So in the previous video we talked about the for in loop, for of loop, but we haven't explored what actually the for of loop internally do. This is newly added in the ES6 and we have already talked about this, so let's cover this up. So in ES6 we have these different generator functions which are started with the asterisk function and they are just yielding the values. These are just new paradigm to manage the asynchronous way of dealing with the functions. So it is actually doing the function pose whenever it is yielding the 1, then it is yielding the value 2. So you can decide what need to be returned from the function at the runtime, right? So every generator function will give you the iterable object. So if you do the console.logx, it will be iterable object which most probably will be an empty array, right? Empty object. So iterable object gives you the generator function x, and whenever you do the x.next, what it is giving you? It is giving you the first yield value from the function and done as false, because we still expecting more values. So now the next do whenever we do dot next again, then we are getting value 2 and done false, and we are again doing it, then obviously we don't have the new value coming from function because it's not yielding another value, it is yielding only 2 values. So value undefined done is true, right? So this kind of a code which we are writing using dot next function on an iterable object, that can be done with the for of loop. So for of loop is actually used to iterate on the iterable objects, and it is internally doing dot next to get the values from an iterable object. So generator function, forget about this for now. I used it to create an iterable object, but this iterable object can be an array. Array is already an iterable object, can be a map, can is already an iterable object. But if you wanted to create an iterable object, some custom iterable objects which is generated by the generator function, you can do something like this. So for of loop, you can see it will be printing the values one by one. It's printing 1 and 2, right? Here I close the iterator, but I can return all the values 1 and 2, right? So now iterable objects are array is always an iterable object, and you can just run the iteration, it will just print all the values under it. Similarly, there is a map, you can get all the entries inside the map because map is an iterable object. So all different kind of a collections, map, set, array, weak set, weak map, all are iterable objects, and you can run for of loop onto them to get the values out of it, like for in loop is there. Okay, this is all about the for of loop. This generator function we will talk more in depth when we discussed ES6.